We Christians should be people in the world, but not from the world. We should be faithful to our duties as citizens of the earth. We should accept the age and the culture. We are part of it, but not uncritically. We should not lose our identity. So I think it's a great challenge for us, this balance between the inculturation, to be the part of the culture, not to be the counterculture, the ghetto, but not to lose our identity in the world, to be critical. And this balance between the solidarity and criticism, it is the art of the existence of Christians in the world. And I think today it is perhaps more difficult because the world is really very complicated. I think the Pope John Paul II and the Pope Benedict closed with a great dignity the long period of church history. It was the period of confronting the modernity. At the beginning, the church was fighting against modernity. During Vatican II, the church realized that it is not the good way, that we should lead a dialogue with the contemporary world and culture. And after the Vatican II, there were two decades of discussing how to interpret the message of the Vatican II. But now the modernity is over, and I think that with Pope Francis, the new chapter of the history of the Christianity is beginning. It is a new courage to read and interpret the gospel, to go to the core of the Christianity. And I think it's a great chance because the modernity is over. And now we live in the postmodern global world with new challenges, with new dangers, and it needs a new type of Christianity. There were many, many such of reforms and renewal in the history of Christianity. It's not the first time. And always it was connected with some crisis and conflicts. And now the world is really very complicated. It's not easy to find the right answer to all these challenges. But it is our task.